for Heisman and myself because I'm so interested. That's why.
Yeah.
We're talking about meat here. You've brought in different cuts. What's the best? Yeah. What's not so great?
We're gonna choose it and lose it with beef, and especially think about it. You know, taste of the Danforth. It's still barbecue season. The exhibition's coming up. And
I'm eating a lot more red meat in the summer.
And we're gonna do red meat. We're gonna do poultry, lamb, the whole works. But let's start with showing you that first of all, one serving size is about 3.5 ounces. This is a ground chicken.
That's it.
And you're supposed to have this twice a day to three times a day. So everything I'm going to show you, keep in mind that's the portion size I'm talking about.
Okay.
So let's look at meats. These are the meats you want to avoid. Regular ground meat. Now, all of these meats here that I'll show you come in at about 300 calories and 25 grams of fat. I'm going to show you the lean. So regular ground beef, high fat. Mm-hmm. Beef ribs, very high fat. Delicious, but very high fat.
I really like ribs.
Skirt steak, new cut here. It used to be in the States. Very fatty. You can almost see through it, if the camera can get that it's quite a fatty cut.
Okay.
All right. Then you've got here a ribeye steak. The best, but the fattiest of all steaks. And Korean ribs. So all of these are ones that you want to really minimize or avoid because this has got the highest amount of fat and cholesterol. For this little small portion here.
So maybe a treat once a year on your birthday.
Like 300 calories, 25 grams of fat. Now let's look at the good stuff. This is the best. These come in all at 170 calories versus 300 with only about 8 grams of fat.
Okay.
So first of all, eye of round. This is what we use for stewing, for braising. Filet mignon, fantastic, no fat. Flank steak, unbelievable. You might want to marinate that. Lean, great.
Okay,
very good.
Lean ground beef?
Yeah.
Or extra lean?
Extra lean ground beef.
Okay.
New York strip steak is great.
Okay.
A top sirloin steak is great. And a T-bone is not bad. If you take a look, there's very little fat. You want to trim the fat on the outside.
Okay.
And stewing beef. Okay, you got it so far?
Yeah,
you're
going to
become a good
it.
All right, pork. So pork, you know, we don't know, is pork good or bad? I'm going to show you first the worst.
Yeah, I always wonder.
Okay, pork belly. This comes in for 3 ounces, like I showed you before. We're going to bring this over to remind everybody. Is about 450 calories and 30 grams of fat.
Mm-hmm.
Back ribs, pork side ribs, also extremely high in calories and fat.
Okay.
Pork shoulder, which is used for pulled pork, look at all the fat, and you tend to cook it with all that fat, not a great thing. Sausages, salamis, and side bacon, not a great thing. But look at all the good choices we have. All right, so here, these ones were coming in at around also about 350, 430 grams of fat. Here we're looking at about 150 calories and 6 grams of fat, okay? Back bacon, cornmeal back bacon is fantastic.
Perfect.
All right, we've got pork chops, butterfly pork chops, pork tenderloin, pork roast, and even the ham, except there's a lot of sodium. These are all really great lean cuts.
Good to know.
All right, poultry. This poor little ducky, all right? Every time you eat duck, you can say you can burn it to a crisp. You're still getting, for 3 ounces, you won't believe it, you're getting about 350 calories and 28 grams of fat, a killer.
Okay.
The other cuts of poultry, the minute you add the skin, Jennifer, you're adding 8 grams of fat.
I know.
Okay, and it adds double the fat and the saturated fat.
Take the skin off.
And the dark meat has 30% more calories than the white meat.
Why?
Well, it's richer.
Because it tastes better?
It tastes better.
But why?
Okay, but then the lean stuff. Okay, you can get a skinless chicken thigh.
Yeah.
Skinless breast.
So thighs are okay?
Thighs are good. Take off the skin. They're still higher than white, remember. Ground turkey or chicken is great, and the best for you is turkey. That's a turkey leg. Turkey is better for you than chicken in terms of calories of fat. Take the skin off if you can. And finally, let's end up with lamb. Not a lot of choices here for really, really good there is, but bad, rack of lamb.
Oh,
it's so delicious. For 3 ounces, remember that small little portion, about 400 calories and 34 grams of fat. But lamb shanks, which you see featured all the time now in restaurants, is great. Leg of lamb is fantastic. Just trim that fat, and then also a lamb chop is really good.
Okay, that's perfect.
It's a lot of information at Rose's Butcher Shop here, but you know what? If you keep that in mind, and I'll have this all up on the website, people like just take the choices because honestly, one, you're clogging your arteries with the saturated fat and the cholesterol of the high fat meats, and the other way, you're eating a healthier way of a diet.
So if you're going to choose something try to go for these every blue moon.
Yeah, every, and look at how much choice you have.
You have a lot of choice. Thank you so much. I just want everybody to know, none of this meat will be going to waste. Okay. It came right out of the fridge, and it's all going to be cooked and eaten. I just wanted people to know that. Thank you for the truth about meat, Rose Risman. Great information. And, of course, we're going to have all the information on breakfasttelevision.ca. You can follow Rose Risman at Rose Risman or roserisman.com.